T-virus brought me back.
But it's so strong. It fights me for control. I ingest you, I gain control.
A-D-N.
It's headphones deal!
What's up, guys, and welcome back to another episode of Headphones Neil Reviews. I'm your host, as always, Headphones Neil, bringing you my next review in the Resident Evil franchise in the form of Resident Evil Afterlife. So I had a chance to watch the next film, and overall, it feels like a step away or potentially a stepping stone in the franchise, as it was essentially a big, long 2-hour presentation of saving all the group of people that was heading to Arcadia from the prior film. So it was kind of a weird movie just because it ended with the Raccoon Corporation coming after the group of people who are in cryostasis, I guess, and they were saved by Ali Larder and Mila Jovovich. So I'm not quite sure what the purpose of this particular film was. It felt like it was more of like a part one of two of a series, or a part two of two, and something that was better served with the prior film. So I'm kind of holding judgment on how good this film was with the next couple of films that I watch in the franchise, just so I can see if they, how they resolve it, how they take care of it, and all of that. Based on the Rotten Tomatoes score, it has a 21% rating with the critics and 48% with audience, so a little bit worse than last time. So for me, it feels like it's a worse movie just because it felt a lot like Max Payne meets The Matrix, where we have Mila Jovovich and Ali Larder's character in the dual roles of Max Payne, potentially even a Mona Sachs kind of character, and then we have the villain in the form of Wes something or other, who's kind of a blending of Neo and Agent Smith, where he's got the powers of Neo, but he's trying to pull off a variation on the Agent Smith speaking style. And then throw in a bit of Blade in the form of his dogs, who are like zombie dogs with a face opening wide to infect or eat regular people. So that was all kind of weird. So that's kind of why I kind of did like the film, just because there was a lot of Matrix inspirations, and I couldn't quite tell what basically the whole point of the film was to rescue all the people that were heading north to Arcadia and save everyone who was in the cryosleep. But it was kind of the last film, like the ending to the last film, was expanded into a 2-hour big budget film in the form of Afterlife. So basically they could have tacked on about basically the last like 30 or 40 minutes of this film into Extinction and resolved all of it in one film. So if I was to grade it on its own, I'd probably give it about a C, just because it had a good premise in the form of heading to Arcadia, but then nothing really special about it. So it's kind of neither here nor there. So how the next couple of films pan out will affect, I'll kind of do a retroactive grade on this film based on how the rest of the films go. And then the other thing that gave me an issue was the CGI, mostly behind Mila Jovovich, like when she's flying into the landing area in Los Angeles, when she's flying off the building and going quickly. Like, it just felt like a lot of the green screen and CGI effects were very, very obvious. So when it takes me out of the film like that much, that's when it kind of makes it hard to give the film a good grade. And for me, because I know it's so fake, that for me, if I can't tell, then it makes it for a good film, especially when I don't notice it. So that's also what took me out of the film. So I'm kind of going to leave the review here for now, until I can actually give the film a proper watch or watch the rest of the films, just so I can give it as, just so I can kind of see how they resolve it and what they do with it and where the films go from here, just to see if that affects my thinking and importance of this film. But my initial thought is that this film is going to definitely rely a lot on how they handle the rest of the films and stories and all of that. So that's all there is for this particular review. So if you have any comments, feedback, thoughts, or anything on this particular film, then you can find me on Twitter at PatelN01. The website is headphonesdeal.reviews for past episodes, subscription links, supporting the show, and all of that good stuff. And of course, you can get access to the full slate of films scheduled for the month by supporting the show on Patreon at patreon.com/PatelN01. But thanks for tuning into this particular episode, and until next time.